This question is very interesting question because there is a combination of multiple things over there. Okay, first of all, if we start this question, they are saying what is the output of following program, and they have given us the program. After that, they are giving us some of the options. Now please pay attention. First of all, they are saying hash include stdio.h. So now they are going to include the library. Then they are giving the prototype int function f int x. That means it is the prototype of this particular function. Then they are saying int function g int y. Now it is a prototype of this particular function. Now our program is starting with the main function. So when the main is called, it will come inside. It will say int x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 10 and count. So there is a variable x which is having the value 5. Y variable which is having the value 10, and there is one more variable which is count. Now they are saying count is equal to 1, so count is starting with 1. Then count less than equal to 2, the statement is true, but see, it is saying plus plus count. So whenever we are going to increment this one, first we will increment, then we will use the value. Now they are saying y plus is equal to, which signify y is equal to y plus. Now they are saying func fx. So by this, our control will be going to the function, and we know that the x we are passing and the value of x is right now is 5. So 5 is passed over there. Now they are saying int y. So there is one more y which is declared and which is part of function f. And it is saying y is equal to func g x. So now they are going to call function g. By this statement, they are going to call this function function g and passing the value of int x. What is the value of int x they are passing? 5. The value till now is the 5. So they are going to pass the value 5. And now they are saying static int y is equal to 10. So now they are declaring one more y over there, which is of static type. And they are saying the value of this one is how much? 10. Then they are saying y plus is equal to 1, which means y is equal to y plus 1, which is 10 plus 1. And the value will be updated by 11. And now they are saying return y plus x. What is y plus x? Y plus x is 11 plus 5. The answer is how much? 16. So this 16 is returned back. And now they are saying return y. So what we are returning? Whatever the value we have returned from here, the value is going into y. And now they are returning y. So the value of y is returned. So value 16 is returned back to the program. So their first function value we are having is 16. So basically, if we say it is y plus is equal to 16 plus the second we are waiting. When we come to this line, after that it is calling func g. So now it is going to call function g. So there, what x value I am passing? So we are passing the value 5, because it is the local value. So again the 5 value is passed. Now we are having static int y is equal to 10. Is there any meaning of this statement? Y will remain same because the static keyword is there. The earlier value of y will persist. So y value will remain as 11. Now y is equal to y plus 1. So what is the new value of y? It is 11 plus 1, which is 12. Now it is saying return y plus x. So what is y plus x? It is 12 plus 5, which is equal to how much? 17. So the value is 17. Now this 17 value is returned back where it was called. So now this 17 value is given over there. So it is 17. Now it is y plus is equal to 16 plus 17, which I can say y is equal to y plus 16 plus 17. So what is the earlier value of y? The earlier value of y is 10. So I can say that 10 plus 16 plus 17, and the sum will be equal to 43. So by this we can say that the first is 43. By this, it is very much clear that B, C, and D are not the answers. Still, we are not done with the program. The program is still remaining. So now we are continuing with the program, and you can see that the value of Y is now 43. So the initial value of Y is now how much? 43. And even that, we can say that in this particular statement, the value is now 43 and the X value remains same. Now, for loop, we have executed one time, it will come back over there. It is saying plus plus count, it will increment by 1, then use the count value. Then it will check whether 2 is less than 2. See, we have incremented the count by 1, so count become 2. And now we are checking 2 less than 2. And the condition is true. So it will again come down. And it is again saying y is equal to function f plus function g. So here we are again writing y is equal to y plus. First of all, we are going to call this function f. Now we are calling this function f. Which value of x we are passing? We are passing the value as 5. Then we are saying int y. So y is declared. We are saying y is equal to function g of x. And we are again going to call function g with the value of x as 5. And now we are saying static int y is equal to 10. There is no meaning of this statement. Static is only for holding the value. And in the earlier loop, the value hold was 12. Now we are saying y is equal to y plus 1. So now the new value of y is 13. Then we are saying return y plus x. So now we are returning 13 plus 5. So what is the value? 18 we are returning. This 18 value will be returned back to the calling program. And there the value of y is become 18, which we are again returning back to the function where we are. So now the value which is passed is 18. Plus, now we are going to the next statement, which is function g of x. Which value of x we are passing? 5. So now we are going to call again one more time this function. And there static int y is equal to 10. There is no implication of this 10. Y is equal to y plus 1. So this 13 is becoming 14 now. And return y plus x. So 14 plus 5 is equal to 19. Now this 19 value is sent back to the calling function. And the value is taken by 19. So if I tell you that the sum is now become y plus 18 plus 19. What is y earlier? 43 plus 18 plus 19. What is the total sum? Total sum of this one is 80. We can see that the second option, which is 80, is also matching. So the correct option is A. Well, on the very first stage of the loop, we were aware that A is the correct answer. So whenever you are dealing with a competitive exam, you don't have to solve the complete question. If you are very much sure that on very first stage, my first output is matching. So the correct option is A.